process when you consider that, as far as the agenda back here?
We will.
Did you like this? Joanna?
I'll get another.
If y'all wanna take a tour of some of the bathrooms, y'all welcome to kind of walk in there.
So this is one of the smaller bathrooms. There's a couple of bigger bathrooms on the second floor, but
more bathrooms are pretty much the same tile.
Yeah, the design is the same, just the size is a little bit.
Same product, more clean.
Yes, sir.
Of course, you guys come.
Are we allowed to take pictures?
I don't have a problem with that.
Okay.
Jeb, do you have a problem with him taking any pictures?
I'm real easy going, so I don't.
Take all the pictures you want.
Some places.
Yeah, I think we usually do this on this year. So we'll kind of keep going. So the women's bathroom could be exactly the same, but it's kind of going there. The number of toilets.
We're on the first floor, A-Blood, and now we're gonna make a lap.
Yeah, and they kind of see the break room there. We got a couple of bathrooms, similar to the ones you just saw.
Okay, so anytime basically before 1 o'clock.
Yeah, he just wants to take the blood.
was not, I was like, I wasn't really sure. It was all right. Just trying to check the hood. I bet yours not there.
Joey, you want to head, I just kind of brought him in here so we could spread out, but do you want to head upstairs?
Let's walk all the way down, okay. Then hit lower level C, then go up, and then go all the way back.
Okay.
I think that'd be the quickest way to do it.
Right.
Joe, is there a dining area, cafeteria?
Yes, sir. We're going to pass by that.
You want to go ahead and hit that now, Joey?
Yes, sir. That'd be perfect.
Everything inside there is on them.
But the seating is.
The seating is part of our area though. That we lease the space so that's for their use.
How long is it? What is it like? Put it up right now.
Well, everything's different right now because of the virus. But normally it'd be open. Like 7:30 to 5:30.
I think it does like 7 to 3:30.
The daytime crew didn't clean it.
They would do any cleaning if she needed it help with it.
I mean, the tables. So we'd have to do the tables, but the tables have to be cleaned during the day.
If it got cleaned, if it needed to be cleaned during the day, they would take care of it. They would kind of be floating and doing whatever they need to do throughout the day. So they typically don't get very dirty, and sometimes even our proprietor of the cafe should be out there cleaning.
For nighttime classes,
yeah, usually vacuuming. They don't vacuum. It's usually kind of like a wave of vacuum as they're kind of vacuuming.
You know, that's the purpose of this bid. Right now, we have 3 days on staff, and we're looking for night on staff.
We hope to fill the night time on cleaning for children, so that we're in a very limited capacity building. We usually have 400 to 500 people here a day. We're probably more like 10% of that, 30 to 40 people a day. So, in fact, this is probably the most people that have been in the building. 9 months with y'all's business here. So.
Now, was this, did I see it correctly that this was put up for bid not too long ago and for some reason it wasn't awarded?
No, this was not put up for bid.
We posted it, but we canceled it before we had a site visit or anything. That was right when the pandemic started.
Okay, gotcha.
So we canceled it, but at this point we got to go ahead with it.
Yeah. Okay. That's right. Man, that's been a long time ago.
Yeah, but we never received any bids. We never even had the site visit. It was canceled
about 3 days
ago. Did you bid out this year?
Yes.
Yeah. And that was awarded.
That was awarded. Yes. We got to schedule that too.
Yes.
So I guess we can head this way now?
We can head out here. I can look around this way, or you can go out and turn left.
The floor, Joey, is the floor work, is it separate contract altogether?
So we posted this.
So the spot cleaning is part of the nighttime plan, when necessary, but we cleaned the carpet itself.
So after we posted it, because we got.
So the same thing with the, like the, one of the general conversations about the DCT, we would handle the stripping and refinishing of that. The only thing with the nighttime, contract be responsible for sweeping, spills, wiping spills and stuff like that, mopping it, I guess.
There was a separate bid for a one-time carpet cleaning.
Okay.
This contract?
Yes, sir.
It would have been on the, for the bid?
Yeah, no, for the building, for the. Well, probably for the bid.
Yeah, so this information would be listed with the bid, and Jeb would be the best one to ask about that.
Okay.
If you need a copy.
Okay, awesome.
Yeah. So, and I think most of y'all have been in some kind of conference room. So here's our, the conference room is kind of similar layout. Most of our conference rooms are all this main strip here.
Do we clean the computers?
So the computers y'all would clean, you would just kind of wipe down. There's usually a special process that you usually clean them out so they don't start to mock. We kind of want a print shop here for their track. They usually put it outside during the day, so that can only be a daytime staff thing. So not a lot to really do inside the print shop. For the building or for the court? So there's just two of them. They're basically. And I want to show you this one area here. You're trying to step on this side of the crazy automatic door. Little janitorial rooms. So this is where our supplies are stocked. There's a couple other smaller places throughout the building where there'll be toilet paper and other cleaning supplies. Of course, with this contract, we provide all of the supplies. The nighttime crew would just be responsible for replenishing during their when they clean.
How about the janitor carts? That's
so I think what we're going to do is just use our janitor carts. It's probably the easiest thing to do. So have them stocked up with stuff to use. We have four of them. So if there's a need for any more,
pretty much labor.
Pretty much, that's exactly right.
Do you supply the vacuum cleaner too, or do you have to bring your own vacuum cleaner?
The vacuuming is probably gonna have to be, we only have two vacuums, mm-hmm. So I imagine whoever's coming in is gonna come in with more than two people, so mm-hmm. They're probably gonna have to provide more vacuum if needed for that workflow.
Is there a separate place for the nighttime contractor put his equipment versus the daytime guy?
Some details we'll have to work out on that when we finalize the thing. It's probably going to be in the same vicinity. There's not a lot to do in here, so we have a small shipping area here in one bathroom. The bathroom consists of one toilet, one urinal. It's all hard floor. I don't think really need to go in there, but it's just that would be a sweet thing, and our daytime crew takes care of a lot of that too. But there may be times when they may ask the nighttime to help with that, but for now we'll kind of see on the map the size of it. Not a big area by no means, but at least we want to show you how kind of it's this same kind of floor here, like concrete. But you wouldn't have to do any cleaning in the actual, there's a giant warehouse out there, you have to do any cleaning in there. Sweep and mop, that's right.
Dumpster's outside of the corner.
Okay, okay.
So, if necessary to pick up, yes, so they need to be checked and emptied if they're full. But typically during a daytime, day four, we need to grab that stuff. I guess, so some people are there 24 hours a day, so I guess there's a possibility they could be filled. But
we're not sweeping and blowing the.
No.
The doorway is good.
You guys give out like badge access?
Yes.
To vendors, yeah.
So and some of that information should be in the bid too. And please too, like Jeff was saying, if y'all have any, as we kind of go through, if you think of any questions, you want more information, please submit it in writing to make it more official. Just more of an informal kind of let you know where we're at.
Sometimes we just have to think out loud.
Yeah, the questions that are answered in writing become part of the bid. So,
and everybody will be able to see those, correct?
Yes.
Good deal. Let's move on. We're going to make a left here. Pay out that
Joey, glass cleaning? We are in the C building now. This is the middle level. This building essentially is the same as the others, but also has a basement level. So we're going to go down there now. If anyone needs the elevator, it's right here. But otherwise, we'll take the stairs.
These are only 2 at a time on elevators.
That's what they're asking for.
This area we have to clean too.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. That's so nice of you.
Thank you. Mama met Ray some way. She popped my bottle if she saw I was doing right.
No, that's great.
We've got the restrooms over here. This building is pretty much laid out the same on all three levels, so you'll have a restroom in the same spot.
Is it just one step from four?
This building, I'm not 100% sure, I don't come over this.
But again, you know, on this side of the wall, it's a cubicle carpet. The square foot is mentioned here. We're welcome to show that to you if you like. But pretty much more of the same kind of layout with the offices and cubicles.
All right, we'll make a lap similar to how we did in the other building.
We've been 24 hours, not 24 hours, but
different.
So, the
24 hour is actually.
We have a break room over here. That'll be a similar break room on each of the three floors.
Is that an area that would not be
clean? This, and the interior here, we have server rooms and things like that. That would not be clean. Okay. Those areas are in green on the map that you have there. Joe, you want to turn them around, or do we need to see back here?
No, they won't be doing that.
Okay, we'll just turn it back around.
Okay.
I don't think there's any verbiage in there that captures it specifically. That would be something that would be following up.
I guess that would apply for every office. Don't touch a desk or anything.
Usually not.
Okay. Unless it I'll was, ask it, just to make it official.
Probably. Yeah, make it official, man. Sometimes I open my mouth and I try to say what makes common sense. They don't always make common sense. Mm-hmm. Let's head back upstairs. So anybody wants to take the elevator, we're going to go up two flights of stairs. We're going to go to the second floor, and then which is a lot like the first floor. This is the only anomaly where there's three floors here in the basement. Well, the magic guy. There's a data center down there that's fantastic.
A what?
A data center. So it's the whole state, these giant servers and computers. It's very cool. So we're going to go all the way up this time.
Did you say this is a sleeping mop area too?
Yeah,
I'm sure what we're here.
Thank you.
Conference room, bathroom.
Yeah, same layout.
Same as.
Yeah.
And we speed things up. We kind of skipped over that ground floor. It's again the same layout. We had a question earlier about some vacant areas. I believe this is where we have the most unused space. Joey, we had a question earlier about vacant offices. I feel like this wing is probably the one that is most vacant right now.
It is. Typically, it would still be following the vacuum situation, the exact vacuum. We'll shift some people over here eventually and have to folks in there.
Okay.
Oh, we'll make a left again.
This is all, everything to the side of the walkway, the glass walkway we came through, this is all C-building. C has three levels.
I bet you this is us.
They doing a pretty good job.
They are.
They are doing a pretty good job.
They are. Even though they haven't been here 9 or 10 months, though.
As far as like dust and stuff, they're staying on top of all that.
There's nobody in the building.
10 months. Right, since 10 months.
But dust is still going to circulate through the air system and stuff. You still got dust.
We do any recycling?
Well, we do have recycle bins. I believe most of it should be empty during the day, but as Joey mentioned, there may be some. Joey, can you?
Mm-hmm.
Joe, we had a question about emptying recycling.
So recycling, no. Cardboard in designated areas would be removed to the cardboard bin. But the recycling, we handle that with our janitorial
staff. They get all of it, okay.
Okay, so just cardboard and trash?
Yes, ma'am.
That's the dumpster right there.
That is, and if you look out this window here, you can see our dumpster. And so, a very nice generator.
We have four generators total. We got three that size because that data center that was in the basement does the data for the entire state, and it can't go down.
Absolutely.
Yes. Or my bad.
How about shredding and stuff? Is that
right there, the top of it, there's actually some stuff you can go down to several points to get. I think there's three doors you can access to get out there.
Or do y'all have somebody come and shred?
The shredded material would just be paper, which the daytime staff should have handled, right, Joe?
That is correct, yes. Okay.
So we crossed under here earlier to get into everything. Over on this side is the C building. That you can see the warehouse back here, where we took a quick trip down that way earlier, and mm-hmm. we're heading back into B now.
So we walked down that hill, it's actually that little corridor there, kind of leads out.
The main lobby is in B?
It's really A, but it's right at B. That's a, okay. B is, so this is the corridor from C to B now.
Right.
So really the only thing in B is the, I guess the main lobby kind of is B, I guess. Yeah, I guess it would be B.
The supplies, paper products, do you guys
have? We provide those.
Okay.
So we're just going to go on this side. We're not going to go in HR, but HR is the same layout as this. There's just a few more offices, but we're not going to visit there. I think they have some judges in there today, and we don't want to interrupt them. We don't want to get no judges mad.
Absolutely.
I'll be in the bread line. So I don't want to get the red line, but it's the same layout. If you look on your paper, there's just a few more offices over there. There's a men's and women's bathroom in there, but they're very small. I think it's like three stalls and two stalls. That's right. So we left some of those rolls are interchangeable. We left them because we had so much of them in stock. But we shifted most of it to this pull out one, it's kind of a little bit softer. But there's a combination of them throughout the building.
Okay, and so the soap.
Yes, sir. We provide the soap refills, and they'll be in the janitorial closets and available as needed.
So we just bring the disinfectant in
the car. That's right. And some of the disinfectant, I believe, is. Included, and I think there was some contradicting terms in the contract. So if you want to ask that question to verify it, it's my understanding was we were going to provide the cleaning stuff.
Oh, okay.
But I've been known to say the wrong thing. I let the legal folks deal with the legal stuff.
So we'll head down there.
So I would say this is the most important part of the building. Because the executive staff sits over here.
Yes.
I don't sit over here. They got me down in the dungeon somewhere. This is where all the
people are. Got a nice desk. Must be the captain there. Sure. Gotta be.
Yeah, that's a big office.
I think that desk. Yeah.
I think on a busy day we have 500 people here. But when our coffee
rooms, we have a lot of visitors because we host conferences here and training. That's how we have all those extra rooms downstairs. And on a busy day, all those could be full.
Yes, I always tell my janitorial staff, like, if anything's got to mess up anywhere in the building, don't let it be here. Like, make sure those bathrooms are always stocked, make sure there's always soap, toilet paper, because our director sits here,
and our COO, who I report to sits over there, and we don't want them unhappy.
Mm-hmm.
That's, we keep them super happy all the time. Mm-hmm. But that's
the bathroom. They're the most important bathroom to me. They smell bad. They smell earthy.
But this, to me, if y'all want to take a look at this, knock-knock! That's the biggest bathroom in the building here. You want to check it out?
So it's funny, so the men's bathroom is enormous, and the women's over here got like three,
like a movie theater bathroom, yeah.
Stall. We got like 9 urinals there, 9 stalls, and if you look at the women here, like 3.
Knock, knock.
And I see a door on the other side. Is that an opposite entrance?
It's a pass-through to like a little janitorial closet where there's some place to get water from.
Oh, okay.
So that's our biggest bathroom.
4 stalls.
Yeah, this is a little small one here.
Yeah. We got more.
I
do. Can you guys?
Definitely here.
Yes.
Definitely.
This would be one of those where you kind of, this is one where you definitely want to come in and wipe it down, wipe down anything here, and kind of make sure the floor's clean.
And waxing. You guys?
No waxing.
No waxing.
No waxing for y'all. We handle that. We strip it. We, if any major carpet cleans, we handle that with usually a yearly contract separate from this. Now, if y'all saw a big stain on there, y'all, we would spot clean it.
Okay.
Yeah, that's what y'all would be responsible for.
Okay, Luke, yeah. That is the
oh, guess we got to make our loop, yeah.
What's that?
Yeah. Make our loop, because they have to catch another one.
Yeah, we don't. Yeah. We'll go this way. We'll go catch up with you, Jim. So so this is kind of more of the same layout where there's a few offices, primarily more cubicles.
Mm-hmm.
That's a library?
Yeah, for general counsel.
Okay.
Then the only thing you'd ever do in there is probably just vacuum.
Vacuum.
Light reading, I don't know. Not on top of that. Jennifer, how are you doing? So, we got scuffed up floor there.
Oh, that's kind of rough.
That's a scuffed up floor there. There's somebody been there dancing, right?
Right. Or playing basketball.
Yeah. So I think somebody went and did that on purpose, didn't they?
This
is
the bottom of the shoes.
Yep.
The heels.
We cut the tail.
Okay, nice.
So it's really a neat building. It's very open. You know, I've been surprised at how well my folks have been able to do to keep it clean.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they did.
I'm amazed, you know, they...
And it's just two of them.
So we got, there's actually 4.
Oh, okay.
We got 2 temps.
Oh, okay.
So I'd like to give the full credit to just the 2, but we're going to have to give those temps.
Yeah,
the
go right ahead.
Yeah, there you go. One of those temps might be the hardest worker out of all.
Exactly.
Oh, wow.
Yes, sir. You kind of see we were just right here in that break room. We just made that big loop.
Okay.
We'll cut through. That's the bathrooms we were in.
Okay.
As you can see, we have not passed a lot of people here today.
At all.
Not a lot of people.
I saw that lady in there. I think she was her and the front lady at the front.
Yeah. So, like you see somebody out, but
almost scary.
So my folks are facilities. So I have the warehouse, the print shop, janitorial, security, the fleet, and maintenance.
We need a couple more.
So my folks are always here. So, but they're the bulk of the people that are in the building.
You said earlier that we, as far as parking, we'd be responsible for spot cleaning.
Yes.
What about buffing? Is that
no buffing?
I believe we've seen everything, Joey. We've got the elevator here for everybody.
Thank you, sir.
We're responsible for these, right?
Yes. Dusting, cleaning, wiping. They're actually, they're very clean right now, as far as the bathroom. We put a lot of effort in trying to get them cleaned up. They're dangerous for sure. But something like that, we're probably looking at a way to
recovery agents. I got on my to-do list of things to look into.
The daytime staff has worked out well to have some permanent employees. We found that they have done having a permanent employee that we get better results. That's worked out well, but yes, but it's yet to be seen what happens when we go back to full capacity.
I can only imagine.
It's not too bad up here with just offices, but as we mentioned earlier, we do get a lot of visitors here because we host conferences and training in all these rooms here on the first floor, and so that can generate a good bit of traffic.
My mother was telling me that she worked at the state for 30 years, she said, I've never been to ALC.
Yeah, we're kind of out here waiting.
Yes, you are. I'm going to be the daytime visitor
outside. How long has that been
the case? So we brought them in, we're about 10 months in, I think around January is when we brought them in here. But we haven't had nighttime.
Is that the daytime?
Yes.
Is that your desire to continue on with two vendors day?
So it's not two vendors, it's really, it's our employees. So we have two permanent employees that work for NCAOC. And as it stands, that is not going to change. So we will keep those employees with us.
And you have the temps to disinfecting your additional stuff.
Just doing it, they're all disinfecting clean. We're kind of working as a team until we got the nighttime in place. Because really when it's a full, we're a full house in here and there's 500 plus people in this building, the sheer thought of more people cleaning this building would be insane. But the two people doing the recycling, doing spot cleaning, getting any trash that kind of pops up and that overfills during the day is more like it. So our plan was to get these folks here with a vested interest that are more, to be here during the day that everybody sees and there's no changeover. They see the same people, they need them, they have their email. It's associated with it. That's the business model we're kind of going with.
I apologize in advance if I didn't say it, but you didn't specify how many employees you thought that we need to bring in. So I see some of them. So
I don't
specify. I didn't see that.
So that would be something you would determine in your scope.
Gotcha.
And kind of put that.
Yes. Yeah.
I think after talking with some cleaning crews, some folks do a mass amount of people. They might bring 10 or 12 in, or you might have some people just do four in here and spend more time in the building. But we'll leave the scope up to the individual. I don't think there's a right or a wrong way.
Nope. And the intention is 6 p.m. is there a set time?
There is a time mentioned in there.
6 to 5.
Yes, I believe that's what it was.
That's when you can, like you said, the plan is up to you. If you could get it knocked out in 3 hours, that's great.
You don't have to be here.
Between those hours, it doesn't.
Yeah. You don't have to have somebody here by no means.
Yeah.
Do you have a targeted start date for this contract?
So our initial plan is we're considering February 1st. Now I say that with a grain of salt because it could change. We've heard about some funding issues and all that. That the funding issue is not going to impact us, but it may impact the start date. So I think the ideal situation is looking at February 1st. In the event that they have and I don't even want to put this out there, but they do a full shutdown of the court system and they were to close this building, they haven't closed it yet, it may delay it. But we'll hope that doesn't happen. I'm told we're going to shoot for February 1st. So it'll be up on us quick.
Yeah. They did shoot down. Shut down, of course, for 30 days, right?
Have you had positive cases in this building since?
We have been very lucky. We have had a couple of positive cases, but they were not in this building when it happened. So we are
blessed.
Not the doctor. Many of us. So we have been very cautious about quarantining folks. I had one of my knucklehead maintenance guys had a small get together. I think 5 of the 7 ended up getting COVID. He was one that didn't, but he got his
knucklehead.
Yes, sir.
Would we have to do an advanced cleaning for to continue with that zero cases in this building? Would that be something to consider in our scope?
I think you can include it, but it's not required.
Not required.
If it's something that you want to, you know, put forth, definitely welcome to do that. But I've been thrilled at how well they've kept this building clean.
Yes.
And if you'd have came in here probably 30 minutes earlier, you would have seen one of the people in here wiping everything down. And if you come back in another hour, you'll see them in here wiping it down again. So any high touch areas,
okay,
I'll have them go through any areas that we kind of saw, and they'll be cleaning it. Because, man, you know, right now, safety first, you know. Y'all are the heroes right now, all the janitorial.
Oh, we're just knuckleheads.
He's a maintenance guy. Maintenance, not janitorial. He's a knucklehead.
We've all been knuckleheads before.
We have been, so he's my young knucklehead, but he, my janitorial staff is more seasoned and much more smart. They've done a fantastic job.
During that time, is there a certain, I guess, just a once lockdown of everything will be sufficient, since there's probably going to be many people here since the daytime's getting a lot of it to do?
Possibly, yes. And probably, you know, in my mind, and like I said, we'll work out, because it is a unique situation where we'll have some daytime folks and nighttime. I think we get a chance to kind of build on that. So, you know, I envision when the nighttime starts, I'll have some of my daytime folks come in, and they get to know each other, kind of work with each other, show them what they're doing, and kind of talk about some expectations. And then they become, I think there's a mention in there that says, hey, you're going to communicate with the daytime of anything that overlaps. I'm easily accessible via email or telephone call, so it should be a pretty good,
idea, because a lot of times the day shift and night shift, they clash.
That's right.
Night shift, you get it, day shift, you get it, kind of.
We're not going to have that clash and stuff. It's a great group to work with. I just know as we kind of spin back up and gear back up, we can't keep the building as clean as it is right now without having somebody come in at night.
Then to be notified once your pulley's back again?
Yes, I would gladly notify. Honestly, I think we're probably looking at summer based on what I'm hearing.
Yeah.
But meanwhile, we're not gonna wait until the summer and say, "Oh, come in here and start cleaning this building." We want to get somebody in here. We're gonna go ahead and get the lay of the land, do any cleaning that needs to be done, kind of leading up to that. Yes, sir.
So we're to bid under the assumption of a full building.
That's what I would do. Mm-hmm. I would definitely do that. So I think that's the way.
Yes, I've heard two different numbers, 400 or 500 people at top.
So top max capacity in the building, people that are employed here, is in the 400 range.
Okay.
I think that may even change. I think COVID's going to permanently change that, where some folks can be able to work from home moving forward. That's speculation on my behalf at this point in time. It should be taken as such. In the event when training opens back up, we do some law enforcement training here, so you could potentially see 500. So a possibility to see much more during the day if there's any of the training going on. Usually what that means is extra trash, bathrooms may be a little bit dirtier, but meanwhile we'll have our daytime staff kind of hit that track up at the same time during the day.
Who does the inventory of supplies? We need something, who do we go to?
So what we'll do is, the method that we have set up right now is we have our main room is stocked, and we have a person from the warehouse that goes in and checks it daily and sees what needs to be replenished. In the event that you needed something, that's a detail we'll probably work out, where you'll either go through me or directly through the janitorial staff, but we stock it in-house in our warehouse, so it's accessible for us to replenish. Like if you came in tonight and you said, we don't have any toilet paper, that's bad business. So we need toilet paper, we'd make sure it's replenished that for the next night coming in here. So, and, you know, we're going to work out some of the details as we get into it because of the unique situation. But I think the unique situation is actually going to be good. I don't think it's going to be a bad thing. Unless some people start pointing fingers, but I don't see that being an issue. If it is, then we'll have to figure it out.
It's an opportunity.
But I think it's a good thing. And we saw a lot of changeover during the day. We didn't have the buy-in, we didn't have the folks were coming and going, and our way to address that was, hey, let's make these employees ours, we're gonna get that pride of ownership, the buy-in, where they're us, they get the same benefits as us, and then we're gonna bring in a nighttime crew to do all the heavy lifting. But no, you know, just to do that deep cleaning each night. And unfortunately, COVID kind of hit and made it where we had to delay that, but I feel like we're gonna keep delaying if we don't go ahead and do it, so we're gonna move on with it. But like Jeb said, send your questions for clarity, make them official,
send them as instructed on here. It'll become part of the bid document. If y'all think of anything else, please send those questions. I think everybody got my card. Feel free to email me. I can pass on anything to Jeb.
We still have anybody that needs anything.
Did anybody leave anything in the conference room?
Nope.
Yes, I need to sign out.
All set.
Thank you so much, man. Thank y'all for calling, man.
Oh, thank you.
Y'all stay safe. Happy holidays.
Oh, you too. Merry
Christmas. Jeff wanted me to make y'all wait outside today, but I told him it was too cold.
You said just us.
It was actually my